Okay, happy people. So today we are going to be doing an unboxing. Actually, two unboxings because I got two of these things. For my birthday, which was just a couple of weeks ago, I received brand new cookware. So I thought I was about to open them and wash them because we're about to use them. Why not just do the unboxing so everybody can see? So first things first, I end up getting the Stackmaster Minis. It's a non-stick space-saving cookware. This is a mini. And the second one is the Gotham Steel. Ooh, this is heavy. Gotham Steel 12-piece set. This is non-stick titanium copper and ceramic stronger than ever. So, first, we'll open the small one. I need new pot sets. My last very good pot set was probably about 12 years ago. I mean, I still got it. It's still good, but I want something new. So this is awesome. So let's see here what we have. I kind of had already opened this before because I was curious about how small it is. So let's just see. I don't know if y'all can see it. But, alright, here we go. I'll open it upside down. Okay. So this is 5 pieces included. Okay, minis. Oh, that's cute. Look at that. Little bitty pan. Single serving. That'd be great if you ate eggs, omelets, I mean, things like that. We don't eat eggs, but I'm going to find something useful. Very cute, very cute. All right, we got a lid. Definitely does not go onto that. All right, we got two little pots. Make some sauces and eats. That's cute. Then you got like the little wok one. That's cute. The little wok. Gotham still. That's cool. Alright, so this lid goes to that one. That's cool. And 5 pieces, y'all. Definitely gotta wash them. But that's cute little mini set. I like that gray. That's cute. They have little rubber handles on them that are gray. It's flexible at the end. I don't know if y'all can see that. Like, it really does bend. There's metal here. Metal screws here. I like that this is poked out a little bit because, man, you get that little gunk around the edges, you know? Seems smooth. This has a rubber handle on it, too, with the metal. Again, the tip sticking out. All of them seem to have that metal. That's flip. That plastic that's very flexible. I'm hoping that's silicone. Alright, then you get instructions. Let's see here. Gives you best performances. Do not use non-stick sprays. That's very good. No non-stick sprays. This is supposed to be non-stick itself. It has an oven use up to 500. You can wash it with water. It is dishwasher safe. Pretty much things like that. No abrasives. An arbitration agreement. Okay, I've never seen that with your product. Okay. Resolution by binding arbitration. Waivers of class participation. Okay, small claims. Definitely going to have to read that in the full. But for right now, we'll skip that and move on. So that's very cute. I don't know if you guys can see that very well. But you get 5 pieces. They can almost fit inside of each other, look like. They can. So they're very easy stackable. So when you're putting them away, you got a little weight for all 5 of them together. But that's cool. Alright. That one is done. And let's move on. We'll put this over here. Put all the paper to that. Now, this is what I have been anticipating and waiting on. I want a new set. So, let's open this and see. Can you see that? That's how it's packed in here. I see a lot of cardboard. I see some plastic for sure. Alright, so let's open this bad boy up. Looks like I'm gonna have better luck with this. Another agreement of arbitration. And pretty much the same thing that's in the other one. Do not use nonstick, oven safe, best performances, things like that. So we'll put that over there. First out, some lids. These do not have the little rubber on them. Okay. Has Gotham still engraved in the metal. Yep. Looks like all of them do. Another lid. One more lid. This is, by the way, a 12-piece set. Alright, so we got 4 lids already. And a lot of cardboard, but I guess we don't want anything to be scratched or broken when we get to it, right? Okay, the steamer itself. That's pretty big. That's a pretty wide steamer. Definitely bigger than my hand, so that's cool. Some of them be small, y'all. Alright, next up, another lid. Okay, out of 12 pieces, how many lids do we have here? This is a square one instead of round. Has Gotham still on it, too. Found it. Let's move that. First one. Have everything wrapped with tape and plastic. Okay. Got them still on the bottom, just like the others. Pretty much looks like the larger version. There is no rubber tip on this one. This one would be great for that. Like they have on these. The rubber tip would be awesome, right? So you wouldn't have to worry about burning your hand as much. Gotham Steel. New and improved update. Put the rubber tip on everything. That would be awesome. Okay, am I going to need some scissors to do this? I'll be right back. Alright, got the scissors. So we can cut this open. So I don't have to sit up here and play with it all day. Alright, we got another flat pan. Again, without the tip. I want the tip on all of these now that I've seen those small ones. That's very cute, but again, the gray bottoms, which is very cute. Got them still engraved. This one seems to be engraved a lot more than that one. Much deeper. But same thing. Still got a metal handle. Got them still on the back of that. Square pan. That lid goes on that one. All right. That's pretty cool. They're shallow, but still cool. Good for sauteing everything like that. All right. That's the end of that side. So let's go to the other side. And that is it in it. Here are our pots. First one up, a smaller one. They have a little weight. I like that, but not too heavy. You can still work with them. Not worry about breaking your wrist. Much deeper. Definitely a saucepan right there. I like how the handle has this little groove right here. Put your thumb in perfectly. That'll work awesomely. Pot of them all. Okay, they have Gotham still engraved on everything. Both sides. They really want you to know. That's about my hand can fit in there, so that's good. I would say definitely a 4 to maybe 8 serving pot. Again, I like that gray. I gotta keep saying that. The gray is very cute. I like the darker gray finish. I just hope these hold up. This seems very heavy. That's good. It would be great if they had, and I'll say this one more time, this little silicone or plastic on these larger ones. That would be awesome. Especially if it was on this, like the ends of that. So, Gotham still, step your game up. That's your upgrade right there. Put these little things on there. At least let me be able to buy them and put them on there myself. Since I already got the set, I don't want to buy another set. But now, let's see here where all these lids go to. This lid definitely goes on that. I wonder if it'll fit something else too. That lid goes on that one. And we have a lid for that one. And we have one more lid. This looks like over your frying pan almost. This guy does not come with a lid. Oh, that's too bad. So, you get 6 pieces to cook in, and you get 5 lids and 1 steamer. This guy should have came with a lid. That would have been better. This sits on that perfectly. Now, they don't have Gotham still written on it, huh? Why not? Well, what do you know? Perfect fit on there. So all together in this set, it is a 12 piece. You get 5 lids, 6 pots, 1 steamer. I really wish they would have put a lid on that one. That would have been awesome. But overall, they look pretty heavy. I do like the color. I like the handle designs with all the little indentions in them. That is great. This right here, I like that the little screws are sticking out, right, instead of stuck down off in there because it gets that little gunk and you can't get them out. So that's much easier. Actually, it's the ones that's on the back. That's probably going to be a problem. See that? They seem to have little plastic. Yeah. Okay, I don't know if you guys can see that, but there's little plastic rings right there. I guess that's going to help with heat, probably. Make sure you don't burn yourself. And I hope it doesn't get all that gunk in there. That'll be awesome if that helps with that, too. All right, so now this is nonstick. It says needs no oil, no butter. I'm going to use oil and butter anyway, vegan butter. But I went all that on ground. Says nonstick Thai ceramic coating. Okay. And that is about it. Oven safe up to 500 degrees. I have no idea what all of this on the edge is. PTFE, PFOA, PFOS free. What all those may be, I'll probably find out when reading the arbitration. With this. It was an SC on TV, so supposedly you're supposed to be able to take these from the stovetop to the oven without a problem, because they do have metal handles. That would explain why it doesn't have the little plastic on them, right? So that means these definitely cannot go in the oven, even though it says oven safe. Does it? Dishwasher safe. No, it does not. So even though it said oven safe on there, I would be wary about putting these in the oven just because of this right here. Don't want that to melt or start cracking from going from hot to cold type of thing. So definitely not in the oven for those for me. Now these is cool because you can take them from the stovetop to the oven, and you know a lot of pans have plastic handles, so you can't really do that because they'll crack or break or melt, whatever may be the case. That means these lids can actually go in the oven too, because they actually have metal and not the plastic, which is a good thing too, especially when you need to cover things for them to keep steam and moisture in. That'll be awesome. But as a man, I'll say I do like them. I love them. They were a birthday gift. It is awesome. So now I have another set to add to my old set. My old set is still pretty good. Even though I've had it about 12 years, it just, the look of it is not so great anymore. But they still work amazingly. Don't have a lot of scratches. Bought them a long time ago, like 12, 15 years ago. They were the heavy bottom ones. I've broken the lids though, to some of them. But I still have mainly all the pots, and that was pretty much the same thing back then. Made sure there were metal handles so you could go from the oven to the stovetop or stovetop to the oven, things like that. With the heavy bottom ones, you could actually go to the table with them because of the way the bottom was made. I thought that was very awesome. Like I say, they lasted a very long time. I don't have a problem with them now. I still use them. They'll just be incorporated with these. Just the other ones, like one or two lids I've broken along the years, dropping it on the ground or something like that. And aesthetics on the outside. Because they were completely metal, all silver, I had washed them a few times with like abrasive soaps and stuff like that. So they have little scratches on them. But these right here, I gotta remember not to. But also, I put scratches in them with metal utensils. Let me just say that. Metal utensils. But this time, no metal utensils. I actually bought some silicone utensils, cooking utensils to use, and I'm putting all the metal away. I do have plastic and wood, but I bought some silicone because I got a new set, y'all. So I'm trying to keep these just as long, but I'm going to try to do an update in about a month after cooking with these. I'm definitely going to start cooking with these and try to use them for the next month, see how they work, and tell you guys if I really like them. I know this is an unboxing. We plan to make tacos tonight, so I will actually demonstrate probably using this pan tonight. But I gotta go wash all this stuff, so I'm gonna wash it, dry it, get my other stuff set up, and then we'll come back and do tacos. I'll be back in a minute. Alright, happy people. So, I am back. We have our cooking station. I don't know if y'all can see that. I'll change camera in a minute. But, we are going to use the larger sauce frying pan. Have a lid. And we're going to to use the smaller frying pan for the rice. So, but before we do that, I just want to read this because this is good to know if you're thinking about purchasing this or already have purchased it. For best performances, cookware is designed for cooking with or without oil and butter. So you can use oil and butter even though it says you can't, which is good because y'all know I'm going to use it. Use on low to medium heat. That's going to be a problem for me because I cook on high heat. Like, my shit be burning. No. But I cook on high heat. I cook very fast. So we'll see how that work out. Low to medium heat, I'm not with that. Like, I'm a person who turned it up on high. All be everywhere. It is suggested to use oil for the first time in the use. So I am going to use definitely oil in these for the first time. And the other ones, since I haven't used it, I think I'm just going to wipe a little oil in them with a paper towel and put them away. So just like you would do cast iron, but since I'm not using them right now. Do not use nonstick sprays. Surfaces allows for use with metal utensils. Okay, but I'm not going to use metal utensils. I actually bought some silicone stuff for this. So I'm going to try not to scratch it up. However, no sharp objects of any type should be used on the inside or the outside of the cookware. That means don't be using any abrasive cleaners on the outside and things like that. Don't use your fork or knife in here. Cookware is safe to 500 degrees in the oven. Use pot holders or mittens to avoid any risk of burning from handling hot cookware. Of course, because these are metal handles. They are not covered with anything. Cleaning and care before you use the cookware set for the first time. Wash with soap and water, which I did. I washed everything and I dried it with paper towels. It is dishwasher safe, but however, note that shine may become discolored due to certain elements in detergents. I'm assuming that's with dishwashers because of the powdery kind, like it can scratch them and things like that. Hand washing is recommended. To avoid risk of fire and to keep your Gotham steel cookware at its best condition, never leave anything cooking unattended. Never allow anything to boil dry in the cookware. Excessive temperature can cause discoloration of the cookware. If this occurs, do not remove the cookware right away, but turn off the heat and allow it to cool naturally. Be careful when children are around. Okay, so hopefully I don't discolor it or forget this zone and burn it up. But I just wanted to read that because for me, the low heat is going to be a problem. So definitely going to put this to the test, see how it works out. So let's start turning stuff on here. Not even going to try to cook on low heat. I'm a high heat person. I already have the rice in here. It's just some, we're warming up rice. So let me change the camera view for you right quick so you guys can get a better view, and I'll be right back. All right, you guys can see that a little better there. I've turned the heat on. We're going to start with some grapeseed oil in here. A couple of teaspoons there. Going to put just a little in here. This is reheated rice. It's not uncooked. I'm going to put just a little water because I don't want it to be too dry. The smoke you see is not coming from the pan. That's actually from the eye itself because I don't waste the stuff down off in there, and I can't get it out because I don't know how to open that thing up, but we're going to keep on pushing through. I am just smashing down the rice to break up any clumps, mix up my oil and water that's in there. Now, on to this one. It is seeming to heat. The oil is starting to displace itself. So we're just going to use a store brand. This is some Beyond Meat crumbles. Put that right in there. Hear a little sizzle already. Sorry about that, y'all. I had to take a phone call. My sister was calling me. So I kind of cut everything off. But it was already heating, so some of this is already cooked. Like, that's already ready. The rice. But here we go. Turning back up the heat on this. So far, it seems to be not sticking, which is good. The oil seems to be not sticking to the pan. The meat is not sticking. I'm going to add a little seasoning to this, little taco seasoning, since we're having tacos tonight. I did turn the heat down on that because it was just a reheat, so it's pretty much warm already. They do heat up pretty quickly, I'll say that, with that induction circle around the bottom. I noticed that they heated pretty evenly, pretty quickly. I didn't show any like spots, hot spots, like hot spots. So that's a good thing. You don't have to worry about one part of your food being cooked and one part not. Now I'm just going to add a little bit of water to spread my seasonings around there. Alright, so now I'm just going to put the lid on it for a couple of minutes so it can heat all the way through. But so far so good. As you can see, the rice is definitely not sticking to the pan. It's sliding right off without a problem. Actually, you can actually see the oil driplets, so it's not absorbing any oil. Well, the pan is not absorbing any oil, but pretty much, as you can see, it kind of slides right down, no problem so far. No sticking, and I have that on high heat as well. And then I turned it down. Right now it's just on warm to keep it warm while I'm cooking this. Again, I hate that this pan did not come with a lid. This would be awesome right now. I'll put the lid over it to keep the heat in. The handle is not getting hot. That's awesome. It is very cool to the touch, even though the lid itself is hot. Even the little things here, they're not getting that warm. I can actually touch them, which is pretty cool. My handle here is warm here, but not so warm that I can't touch it. So that's pretty good. I do like that. It heats up more closer, but back here, there is no heat. So easily for maneuvering while you're holding your pan. Alright. As As you can see, I got some browning going on in the meat, but there is no burning or sticking to the pan itself. It is so far so good. Now, I'll be right back because that is my brownies and I don't want them to burn. So, be right back, people. Okay. So it does allow your meat to brown without sticking, and that's very good. Because I do want my stuff to have some brown on it. I like the little browning on stuff. But for the most part, we are cooked here and we are all done. So I think I can pretty much turn the fire off on this. Now I'm going to get a bowl so we can see how easily this slides off without a problem. So we got a bowl here. I'm going to pull this forward so y'all can kind of see this. I hope you can. There we go. Let's see. Look at that. Just slides right on off. Nothing left in there but some oil. And that is pretty good. Bottom still looks pretty good so far. Just gotta clean the oil out with this, no problem. Turn that off, we're gonna set that right there. Now, I will say this. With any cookware, I would always suggest cleaning it right after. And these things that I'm saying don't always apply to me because I leave stuff in the pan 2-3 days. I'm horrible at that. Leaving stuff in pots, pans, just covering up, putting it in the refrigerator. But longevity. Wash and clean your pans, pots and pans right afterwards. Store your food in the food storage containers. Wash and clean. Dry them immediately. Like, don't leave them to sit and dry because they get the water spots. And that's how rusting starts, like off in the little crevices. So dry them immediately. Don't leave them sitting wet, which I'm guilty of. So with this new set, I'm definitely going to try not to do that. Going to wash everything as I go. Dry it. Put it away so that way I don't have to worry about so much of the rusting. And again, long longevity. It says don't use high heat, but as you see, I just use high heat. And I'm probably going to continue to use high heat in this. I don't think it's going to be a problem. There were no stick. It did not hold anything in there. As you can see, like right now, the oil is like running down the pan as we talk. Nothing is sticking, and that was on full on high heat. Same thing with the rice, no problem. So overall, I think these are going to be good pans, no problem. Like I say, they got a little weight to them. That's very good. The handles are very sturdy. Seems to be no stick right now. Just remember, your first time use, you need to actually use some kind of oil or butter in them. And then you can go no oil or butter later. But for me, that's not going to be a problem because I use oil and butter. I wish the handles had those little handles like the ones of the minis with the little silicone or plastic or whatever, but not necessarily stuck on completely where you can't take them off. I should be able to add them and take them off as I please. So when I put them in the oven, I don't have to put them on. But that is pretty much it, and I just don't like that the one pan did not come with a lid. That was my only big deal about that. I wish it had came with a lid on it. But other than that, I would say give these pans a try. Like I say, longevity is just how you take care of your pans. So take care of them well, you won't have a problem. And with that, stay happy.